Hey guys, welcome to the channel. Are you looking to keep employees from being all up in your business? I'm talking about seeing costs, voiding transactions, and giving unwarranted discounts. Today we're talking about cash footprint point of sale and employee permissions. Let's get into it. Welcome back. If you're new here, welcome. I'm James. This channel is all about helping you get the most out of your point of sale and time clock solutions. Today we're going to cover what full permissions look like, how to set default permissions and sign-in options, how to set up an employee and assign permissions to that employee. I'm going to show you how the permissions are used in CashFootprint. I'm going to show you how to change users on the fly so we can enforce those permissions. And finally, stay to the end because I have a bonus tip that will show you how to increase the speed of your checkouts. And while we're getting started, let me know in the comments below what your favorite part of CashFootprint is. Is it the inventory management? Is it the customer control? The point of sale reporting? What's your favorite part of CashFootprint? First, go to the tools menu, choose options, click on the business tab, and select employee tab. This is where all of the default user permissions are located. You can also adjust the maximum discount percentage allowed by an employee. By default, the only two permissions that are selected are the allow user to log in and allow user to use point of sale screen. Those are the only two permissions. Anything else that you want to give by default when you add a new employee, you can select here. I'm going to go ahead and leave this as it is and click OK. Okay, let's do a test transaction. I'll show you what the default permissions look like. 3, 2, 1. I'm going to change the price. I'm gonna make it $6 instead of 10. I'm gonna change the quantity to 5, and then I'm gonna void the transaction. I'm gonna hit void, and it's gone. Now let's go add another employee and give it a few different permissions. Click the manage menu, choose employees and employees again. Click the add button in the toolbar. Give this employee a first name, choose Max. You'll give them a username, also Max. Password is 1234. You can do a password hint if you want to. I'm going to also require password reset. This means that when that employee logs in for the first time, they'll need to change the password to something meaningful to them. I'm going to click on the permissions tab, and this is where all of the permissions for the employee will be set. You can choose any permissions you want. As long as the user has permission to log in, they will have access to use any of the other permissions that you select. If an employee is let go, you can come in here and uncheck allow user to log in. So if for whatever reason they get into the building and try to log into the system, they won't be able to. Go ahead and click save, and the new user's been created. Now let's take a look at how these permissions are used within CashFootprint. Go ahead and close the employee screen. Okay, go ahead, smash the like button, hit subscribe, check the notification bell if you want to be notified of new videos. Let's get back to it. And let's go ahead and switch users. I'm going to lock CashFootprint. You can log out if you want to. And then I'm going to log back in as Max 1234. I'll reset my password. I'm going to set it to password. You can verify that. I thought I mistyped it, but got it right. Okay, so now we're logged in as Max. The only permissions that Max has is the ability to log in and use the point of sale screen. So let's see what happens when we try and sell item 3, 2, 1. Okay, added to the transaction just fine. Let's do a change price. Now we have a manager override that is required in order for him to change the price. Let's go ahead and do that. Perfect. Now let's go ahead and change the quantity. We'll just do 5 like our previous example. And then I'm gonna go ahead and try and void. Here I'm presented with another permission requirement. The manager needs to override this as well. Manager, password, and the transaction is gone. So you can see that if the employee doesn't have permission, the manager needs to come and override that particular function. Okay, so now let's cover how do we enforce these permissions for all of the different users that we add. Well, you're gonna need to set up the software so that it logs out after each transaction automatically. Now we'll go to the tools menu, go to options, click on the business tab, choose security. And the very first permission here is lock terminal after each transaction. So let's go ahead and check that and click OK. So now I'll show you what that looks like. After each transaction, I'm gonna process this out as cash, do a 20, done. There we go. So now it's gonna lock the system for the next employee to come in. Very simple. The employee puts in their username and password and logs in. If that's slowing you down during the transactions, you can disable the requirement for the password and it will still be required for managers. I'll show you how to do that. Let's go up to the Tools menu, choose Options. Also on the Business tab, Security tab, the second option is the login does not require a password. Now, this will not affect the manager profile. The manager profile, you can still set up to require a password. I'll show you how that's done. Let's click OK. You're gonna go to Manage Employees, choose the manager account, whoever it may be, click on Permissions, and you'll see here that this requirement right here, always require password for this profile. This means that this employee, whenever it's trying to be used, if they log in, if someone tries to log in as manager because they know the username is manager, or the username is whatever your username is, then if they try and type that in at the login screen, they're also going to be prompted for the password. I'll show you how that works. Let's go ahead and lock. And now you can see that the system is only asking for the username. I'm going to go ahead and type in manager. Hit OK. And you can see it's asking for the password. I'm going to click cancel. And then I'm going to enter in Max as the username and hit enter. And you see there it didn't ask me for the password because that user account is not set up to ask me for a password. Let's get into the bonus tip of the day. So how do we increase checkout time? Let's go to Tools, Options. We'll click on the Terminal tab. Right here in the middle on the right-hand side is an option called Automatically Continue to Next Transaction. Let's go ahead and check that. Click OK. What this is going to do is it is going to basically hide the follow-up screen, the change due screen that comes up after the transaction. So let's ring up the transaction. I want to process this cash. And you can see it moves directly to the screen for logging in for the next employee. I'm going to click OK to log in. And we're ready to ring up another transaction. And I'm going to show you one more bonus tip to increase checkout time. Click on Tools, go to Options, click on the Business tab. Down here on the bottom, you'll see two options for default tender button. Go ahead and select the process transaction and click OK. What this is going to do, let's ring up an item and we're going to process this cash. You can see that the blue highlight is around the process transaction button, whereas before it was around OK. If you click OK, it brings you back to the point of sale screen. Now, when you enter in your amount, say you do 20 and enter on the keyboard, the default action is to process the transaction. So that's going to speed up. You don't have the two steps. All you do is you just type in the amount, hit enter, and it will process the transaction. Okay, check out the recommended video. Browse the playlist for more tips and tricks just like this. As always, like and subscribe. Have a great day, and we'll see you next time.